convergence properties of series. So the first one is, if you have two series and they both converge, then the sum that's created by adding the sequence terms from both converges to the series sum of the first sequence and the series plus the series sum for the second. In other words, you can break up the sum. Okay, so the proof of that is your partial sum Sn for the combo series is equal to this first part here. And this is just a finite sum. And sums you can break up. So you just break that up. And we're going to call the this partial sum for the A sequence to be capital An, and similarly for Bn. So when you figure out this, that's the limit as n goes to infinity of the n partial sums of S, which is equal to the limit as n goes to infinity of what Sn was, which is An plus Bn. And limits, you can break up the sum. So we broke up the sum here. And this first limit is just this series, and the second one is that series. So we're done. In other words, you can break up sums inside these series and write it as two different series. Okay, here's an example of further reasons why that is. Let's say you had this sequence and this one. Okay, well, the first sequence, the series for that adds up to 1, as seen in the book, or you could run the Riemann program. You'll see it turns out to be 1. So, and the second one, we've already seen, sums up to 2. So we expect that the combo sum would add up to 1 plus 2 is 3. So here's the AN sequence and here's the BN sequence. So the sum of, you know, the first four terms of that is adding terms from one to the other. 1 half plus 1, 1 sixth plus 1 half, like this. And you can see that all you have to do is reorder those from these sums and have it be this and this, and that's the sum of the original. And when you take the n going to infinity, of course, you're going to get this and this. Okay, the second property of that first one is the series of k times each of the sequence terms converges to k times the series sum. In other words, you can factor out the k. Well, of course you can, because this series notation is the same as this notation. The limit as n goes to infinity of this partial sum. And in the limit, first you can take out the k out of this partial sum. This is just a sum of numbers, so obviously you can factor out the k. So now you're here. And you can factor out a k constant multiple out of a limit, so now it's out here. And this part is equal to this, so that proves it. In other words, you can factor out a constant out of a series and still get the same answer. Okay, changing a finite number of terms in the series, changing these, does not change whether or not it converges, although it may change the value of the sum. Okay, so I did this kind of change for this example. I have this series here, which we already know looks like this, and we already know it sums up to 2. Suppose we took off we altered it by burning off what's called burning off the first three terms. So we took out the first three and started a sequence or the series at n equals 4. So we burned off n equals 1, 2, 3. So let's analyze what's happening with this. Well, it still converges, maybe to a different number now since we took out these three, but it still converges because if it didn't converge, if it diverged, then 1 plus a half plus a fourth plus this diverge part would end up diverging, because anything that diverges and you add something to it, it still diverges. And that's a contradiction, because we already know that this series here converges. So that means this part here converges. And what does it converge to? Well, it converges to 2 minus the stuff we took out, so it converges to a fourth. Here's another example. N equals 1 infinity of 1 over n. That diverges. Why? The short answer is that 1 over n terms do not dive to 0 fast enough. Another property that we're going to learn later is that for this even to have a chance to converge, the 1 over n, the an terms have to go to 0. Because if they don't go to 0, then it's going to either go back and forth or it's going to add up to infinity. But 1 over n, in this case, that goes to 0, so what's the problem? The problem is that it doesn't go fast enough. It creeps down to 0 very slowly, similar to the way this integral diverged. For the long answer, see below. So anyway, back to this example. So let's say we burn out the first two terms. So we have these two, and then we're going to find out what this does. Again, if this part here converged, then certainly 1 plus a half added to whatever that number was that it converged to would also converge. Okay, but that would be a contradiction since we already know that the total sum diverges. Okay, since that means that this part here must diverge. In other words, if you take out some of the stuff of a convergent interval, convergent series, the series still converges. If you take out some stuff from a divergent series, it still diverges. And here's your analysis of the series of 1 over n. Okay, so this series is shown by the sum of the rectangle areas. See this? 1, that's a 1 by 1, 1 half, because it's 1 half, 1 third, 1 fourth height, 1 fifth. Okay, and this is the curve, 1 over x. So those areas of that shaded in part represent this series. Okay, 1 plus a half plus 1 third plus 1 fourth plus 1 fifth. But you can see that the areas there are greater than the area under the curve, because the area under the curve is only this part down here. But what is that area of the curve? It's 1 to infinity of 1 over x dx. We've already seen that it diverges, and it diverges because that area doesn't dive down fast enough, and so the area ends up adding up to infinity. So our series is greater than something that adds up to infinity. That means it diverges also, even though it's very slow. Another property here is the limit of the an themselves has to converge. If it doesn't, if it does not exist, then those sequence terms are flopping all over the place, or they're blowing up, they're not going down to 0, So that series will diverge. So the limit of the sequence terms themselves must exist for it to even have a chance of converging. Also, if you have a series that diverges and you multiply each by k, that certainly will diverge also. Because again, you can just factor out the k, and k times diverges equals divergent.